beautiful.
Okay. Tell someone else that is beautiful. Thank you. I'm deeply honored to accept this award, this great honor, on behalf of Andrew Ayden, Nate Powell, and Lee Walton, our editor, is right there, top shelf, our publisher. Now, some of you know that I didn't grow up in a big city like Atlanta, or New York, or Buffalo, or Detroit, or LA, or Chicago. I grew up in rural Alabama, 50 miles from Montgomery. Outside of a little place called Troy, my father was a sharecropper, a tenant farmer. I grew up very, very poor, 6 brothers and 3 sisters. Wonderful mother, wonderful father, grandparents, and great-grandparents. When I was growing up, I saw those signs that said white men, colored men, white women, colored women. I'm gonna ask my mother, my father, my grandparents, and my great-grandparents, why? They were, that's the way it is, don't get in the way, don't get in trouble. And I've asked my teachers, why? I had a wonderful teacher who was a homeroom teacher and also the librarian, who said to me over and over again, read my child, read. And I tried to read everything. We were too poor to have a subscription to the local newspaper, but my grandfather had one, and we would finish reading his newspaper each day, but pass it on. So I kept up recurring events. I want to thank each and every one of you for all that you do to help our young people, and people not so young, to stand up, to speak up, and speak out, and find a way to get in the way. Yes, I got in the way as a child because of books. I got in trouble. Good trouble. Necessary trouble. Some of you may not know, my late wife was a librarian. She was born in Los Angeles. She attended LA High, UCLA undergrad, and USC School of Library Science. She traveled to West Africa as a Peace Corps volunteer and came back to LA and worked at the Central Library. And then she got a job here in Atlanta in 1965. We met in 1967, the last day of 1967. And we got married on December 21st, 1968. She taught me a great deal also to have a love for books. I love books. When you're a little child, you had very little money, growing up poor. With books, you could travel. Travel. Imagination. Most of you are too young to know anything about the Sizzler book catalog. That big, thick book. Some people used to call it the wish book. I wish I had this. I wish I had that. So even that catalog gave me some ideas about how I could overcome and do certain things. Some of you know from reading Marge, book 1 or book 2, and now book 3, as a young child, I wanted to be a minister. I wanted to preach the gospel. On the farm, it was my responsibility to care for the chickens. And I fell in love and raised the chickens. And I used to preach to the chickens. And from time to time, I try to baptize some of the little chicken. It just didn't work. But I tell you, as librarian, some of those chickens that I preached to in the 40s and the 50s tended to listen to me much better than some of my colleagues listened to me today in the time. And some of those chickens were just a little more productive. I keep on doing what you're doing. We need you now more than ever before. We've come too far, we made so much progress as a nation and as a people. We don't want to go back, we want to go forward. And save this little piece of real estate for generation yet unborn. Keep it up, keep the faith. When you see something that is not right, not fair, not just, tell people to be brave, to be bold, to be courageous. When I marched across the bridge in Selma on March 7, 1965, I was wearing a backpack before it became fashionable. And in this backpack, I had two books. I thought I was going to be arrested and go to jail. I was beaten and left bloody. And to this day, I don't know what happened to my backpack and what happened to my two books. So thank you, all to the writers, for writing, the editors, for what you do. Thank each and every one of you who serve as librarians to have spread the word, the written word. Help create what Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. called the beloved community, where we respect the dignity and the